Hi, my patrons. We have another question today. This one from Tom. Let me read the question. Tom asks, when someone takes their life with their own hand, does that person go to a lower realm than a person who passes away naturally? If yes, how much time does that person stay in that lower realm before the person goes to the normal realm? Tom, our conversation will be long, because just for remembering, when I took my mastership and my doctorate, the study was in sciences of religion, what means that I had to study many religions, and something surprising, possibly for you too, is that all religions are not of any divine or sacred origin. Okay, how things work. Whenever the command of earth, which are very high beings, perceive that some specific region on our planet in a specific time needs a support, something for rearranging, to put back on the rails, they send an avatar for starting something that will be a religion later. So we can notice that each avatar that already appeared on Earth came for solving, for supporting, for helping a specific region of the globe and a specific time. What doesn't mean that those thoughts would be eternal, right? Obviously, this is not informed to people, so that, for instance, Christians will think that the Bible is eternal. The Jews will think that the Torah is eternal, and so on. We have to have in mind that all religions were born as per a human necessity of a specific region and a specific time, right? Said that, we observe that, for instance, the late religion, all them were spiritualists, let's call it this way. Those ancient religions were all spiritualists. All them trusted in the afterlife. All ancient religions had such a knowledge. Possibly it was heritage from some previous people that had been on Earth. So what I mean is that when Christianism says that suicides will go to hell forever with no chance of pardon, this was a necessity of information the people of that time had, right? It was not a general law for valid eternally. Jewish, for instance, don't admit that a person that committed a suicide is buried in the same graveyard with the other Jews, right? So they are very rigid with the topic of to kill by your own hand. For instance, nowadays, all around the world is increasing the knowledge about the afterlife. That means that we are returning to the old roots that we had already in the past, right? And it is not only our opinion, that is what science is coming closer. For instance, whenever people in universities, mainly in US, are studying consciousness, what are they talking about? They are talking about the spirit. They are just changing the name. Is what the scientists in universities call consciousness. But it is just the same. They are investigating if consciousness can leave the body, if consciousness is able to communicate. So we are returning to the past, right? But what is important? Your question is related to a topic typically from Christianism. It happens that by that time, some 2,000 years ago, it was important not to separate the tribe. They don't want to lose anyone. If we consider what is logical, which is our development of our consciousness or our spirit, it seems that the function of our lives is to be here for a life experience, which will add to our baggage of information more learnings. And that is why we are here on Earth, facing all type of suffering, of all types of situation. That seems to be the goal of our lives. And observe that it is absolutely no logic at all to imagine that God would determine it, that a person that killed by his or her own hand will go to hell forever. Oh my, what is that? Is that divine justice? To keep a person suffering forever because of an action? Does it make any sense? No, it doesn't. And it seems that that is why we are here. And there are many scientists who are observing this incredible net that is the universe. And we are part of this net. And we are all developing all together. So chances will be ever and happen again and again and again. It doesn't matter. So if you ask, what is my opinion? My opinion is that suicide, okay, is not the best option. There is no problem. You try again, and we'll try again and again and again. And that will be the baggage of the person that is crossing these experiences. So there is no hell, there is no heaven. All this knowledge never came from heaven straight to any human. And obviously, in accordance to what the necessity of the tribe. So, said that, I would say that I'm very happy to be working with this large group of suicides. I have 26 mothers who lost their kids or relatives through suicide, right? It's a very large group, much more than I and Lisa expected. But it has been a wonderful experience because all of them are participating perfectly of the experiments. And they will have other chances because that is what is life for. We are here for learning, for adding information, for adding knowledge from one life to another. So no problem. How many times we made something that was not the best choice? But okay, we do it again. It is not that problem as religion says. And just finishing, remember that the religions are a product of human conceptions. Okay, so Tom, I hope that if you have a son or anyone who committed suicide, be sure this person will have the very same chance of reincarnating and starting over and over and over how many times it is necessary for his or her consciousness to cross all these difficulties. Okay, that is not only my opinion, but also the point of view of the spiritualist philosophies. Okay, a big hug to all, and till the next question. Stay well. Bye-bye.